श्री सहारिया जी, डॉक्टर सुवर्ण खरात, श्री धामने जी, फ्रेंड्स, इट गिव्स मी ग्रेट प्लेजर टू वंस अगेन वेलकम यू ऑल. राधा एंड अपर्णा हैव ऑलरेडी वेलकम्ड यू एट द बिगिनिंग ऑफ दिस प्रोग्राम, बट वी हैव आवर चीफ गेस्ट श्री सहारिया जी. स्पेशल वेलकम टू यू सर. Chief Secretary, as you all know, is the busiest civil servant in the state. Yet he has taken time out to come here, so we are really thankful to him. A few weeks ago, he invited us, a team from ORF, and he gave more than 1 hour to interact with us, know our work, and also suggested a few very concrete action points, one of which of course is about school education, and soon he is going to release Aparna's wonderful report. This report is the beginning, friends, of our collaboration with the Israeli consulate. Saharia ji, we had at the beginning of the program a message from the Consul General, Mr. Jonathan Miller. He couldn't be present today, but we had an opportunity to meet Ashwini Bhide, Secretary of School Education, and we had an in-depth discussion along with Mr. Jonathan Miller, and we've decided that in the month of May or June, we will have a much more focused, more comprehensive 2-day conference come workshop on quality enhancement in school education. We will have several participants from Israel and also many who have participated, like Aparna, in the program that Israel conducts on a regular basis. And all of you are in advance invited to participate in that conference. Friends, Aparna's presentation showed us, you know, what a miracle nation Israel is. You know, we don't agree with everything that Israel does, but we have to admire many things that it does and how it has made education the foundation for its survival, for security, for prosperity. A nation that's less than, that has a population less than that of Mumbai, has more Nobel laureates, if that is one indicator of progress, than India, than all of the Arab world put together. It has more PhDs than all the Arab countries put together. It has more innovative products than Indian companies have so far put out in information technology. So we certainly have a lot to learn, and the learning has to begin at the schools. And at the end of the roundtable, I request you to please pick up copies of Aparna's report, which we also brought out in Marathi. Friends, at least some aspects of what Israel is doing are not original. You know, they have been there in our own tradition. Unfortunately, we have not paid enough attention to them. We have not universalized them, such as learning by doing. Learning by doing is the foundation of Mahatma Gandhi's Nayi Taalim, Bunyadi Taalim. You know, Mahatma Gandhi, he emphasized that learning must begin with hand, then heart, and then head. So it's a harmonious development of the hand, heart, and head. The intellectual development, emotional development, character development, artistic development, spiritual development, all this has to go together in education. So if we have to, of course, we have a lot to learn from countries like Israel, not only Israel, but many other countries around the world, all the countries around the world. But we also have to rediscover the tradition of learning in India itself. Some of these concepts are being put into practice in India, and we are very happy to have the practitioners participating in this conference. We have Ashok Kalba representing Vigyan Ashram, Pabal near Pune. Many of members of ORF have visited Pabal. I've gone there myself. I don't know why it has taken so long for the government of Maharashtra to say, as Dr. Suvarna Kharat mentioned in her initial remarks, that the government is going to make vocational education the core of secondary education. This ought to have been done long, long ago. But even now, if government, Maharashtra, takes the lead in vocationalizing, especially secondary education, where we have a huge dropout, but these are not friends, these are not dropouts. The right word to use for them is they are pushouts. They are not dropouts, they are pushouts. The system pushes them out of the education system. They have talent, they have intelligence, they have desire to learn further, but the system pushes them out. So, the learning by doing vocational education is not only for the dropouts or the pushouts, but even those who remain in the secondary stream. And since Shri Saharia ji is here, we really expect the government of Maharashtra to give priority to what has been announced today. We were very happy to hear, you know, this is one educational innovation that we heard today, but there is also another innovation in education that we heard. Dhamne ji mentioned how they have addressed a very serious problem in municipal schools in Mumbai, where some years ago the number of children studying in municipal schools was more than 10 lakhs. It has come down to less than 5 lakhs. Why? Because of the craze for learning in English. You know, this is a big problem in India. We are neglecting our matrubhashas. But we have to recognize that English is also now an Indian language. So how do we harmonize education in our matrubhashas and also education in English? And that is what the corporation has begun doing, and we wish you well, and we hope that you begin to get back children who are out of the municipal system, and not only poor children. You know, the municipal system should be so good that even children of rich families should see municipal schools as their preference. That is the goal that Municipal Corporation of Mumbai should set for itself. I would like to place a few thoughts for the consideration of the Chief Secretary here. We need a very strong partnership between the government sector and the so-called private sector. This divide must end. You know, in India, a large number of so-called private institutions have been imparting education for decades, in fact, for centuries. They are part of the core strength of Indian education system. The government should recognize their strength. Similarly, the so-called private sector should recognize the strength of the government system. And we must evolve a strong partnership. And this is, in fact, one of the objectives of this roundtable. When we say how Maharashtra can infuse innovation and creativity in its education system, this can only be done through partnership. Friends, in the past few years, there have been some really landmark legislative initiatives in the field of education. The Right to Education Act is a landmark legislative step. But as Dr. Montero very rightly pointed out, RTE is not enough. We should have right, not just right to education, but right to quality education, universalization of quality education. Right to quality education, RTQE, is what India needs. He made another very important point that the government must define outcomes, what outcomes we need, and the government institutions and also private institutions should be held accountable against those outcome parameters. We have 24 crore children in this age group. They are our biggest, most precious resource that India has. As Swami Vivekananda said, every child is perfection, divinity, waiting to manifest. So, in this, we have had, Sahariyaji, we have had very good discussion on one topic. Of course, we have had four topics in this round table, but one topic is, what can we do to focus on gifted children? Gifted children is not an inegalitarian concept, friends. It is not against the concept of equality. It is to recognize that there are some children who in some ways are gifted. Let's not go into defining giftedness. Who with special attention can really bloom, can blossom, and can be great assets to the nation and society. And what is that's what Israel has done. Aparna's report, you will see, has actually talked about some very special measures that Israel has to identify these children at the school level and have an institutionalized interaction between these gifted children and the best scholars, best scientists, best artists in Israel. Why can't we do it? I would end my remarks by mentioning something that Aparna very briefly touched upon, and that is that the Observer Research Foundation is contemplating a new initiative. It's called Change Agents in School Education and Research, CASER. And I can see that many of the change agents are in this conference hall itself. We are beginning two initiatives. One is Change Agents in School Education and Research, and one more, Change Agents in Higher Education and Research. My colleague, Dr. Lina Wadia, has just completed Lina and Aparna together, they have just completed a major research study on how the College of Engineering Pune has transformed itself, making use of the status of autonomy that was granted 10 years ago. That report is going to be released soon, but coinciding with the release of that report, what we are urging is don't restrict, don't limit autonomy to just some four or five institutions. There are a whole lot of institutions in higher learning in Maharashtra alone that can become great institutions. Free them up. Liberate them from bureaucratic control. Trust their leadership. So these two friends are our new initiatives, and we request you, we appeal to you to partner with us in taking these two concepts, change agents in higher education and research and change agents in school education and research. Let's make these two initiatives a reality. Before I end, I must recognize, because one very dear friend of mine who is here but who has not spoken, Firoz Ashraf Saab, Firoz Ashraf and his wife and his daughter, they run a unique institution in the slums of Jogeshwari called Uncle's Classes. What Uncle's Classes has achieved in the past 10 to 15 years is truly a mini social revolution on a nano scale, especially imparting, making education possible to poor, very poor Muslim girls. And not only Muslim girls, also Hindu girls. अभी तक जो चर्चा चली है पूरी चर्चा अंग्रेजी में चली है, इसलिए मैं समझता हूं कि कई लोग जो मराठी में बोलना चाहते हैं या हिंदी में बोलना चाहते हैं वो अभी तक शरीक नहीं हुए हैं। इसलिए मेरा आग्रह है, मैं आग्रहाने सर्वांना सांगतो की ज्यांना मराठीत बोलायचं आहे मराठीत बोला, ज्यांना हिंदी मध्ये बोलायचं आहे हिंदी मध्ये बोला, आणि ही चर्चा